Another 5-6 years if he wants.
Triple G Canelo, they're supposed to start meeting today, actually was the first meeting and their announcement. What do you think if it happens this year?
It'd be nice to see it, but I think for Canelo, the smart way to do it is maybe give it this next year coming up, you know, 2016, without fighting Triple G, and maybe fighting him 2017. He gets more experience. He gets two or three wins in between that, more confidence, and then that also gives Triple G another three fights, maybe easy wins because he knocks everybody out, but he might be getting closer to 35, 36 maybe. So the smart way would probably be for Canelo to wait. That fight's always going to be there, and it's, you know, look at Mayweather and
Pacquiao.
And Pacquiao, it took, what, like 6-7 years to happen. And when it happened, it broke records. It sold more than anybody else, you know, any other fight has ever done. So it's not like it was 6 years too late. It still did over 4 million pay-per-view buys. So I think it was smart. I think Canelo and Triple G could do the same thing. They could wait another 2 years, and when that fight happens, it'll be huge. It might be huge, bigger than if it is next year.
Why do you say Triple G has 6 years left? He's 33. Why six? Why not 10?
His health? Well, yeah, no. Six, at least 6 years.
Yeah.
It could be 10. Yeah, because he's healthy.
Very low damage?
He hardly get, you know, he doesn't, he's never, he hasn't been hurt bad. You know, he gets hit here and there, but it's not like he's getting hurt or he's getting any damage to his body. He's healthy. I'm sure he maintains himself. He's not, I don't think he blows up 40 pounds and then has to lose 40 pounds every time he fights. I don't think so. I think he's one that maintains around, you know, 10, 15 fights, I mean pounds. So that could, he could do it for another 10 years. Yeah, I said six, at least six. He'll be close to 40.
Robert, what do you think Mayweather said that it was harder to fight Pacquiao than Cotto or Canelo?
Well, to me it was easy. I seen that he fought it. He had an easy time. I don't think it was that hard. He was inside the ring with him. Maybe he felt his speed or his power, but we thought it was an easy fight for him. It might have been harder than Canelo, because against Canelo it was very easy. You know, Canelo just, you know, didn't fight the way he really should be fighting. I think Cotto was difficult. I think Cotto was a little bit difficult than Pacquiao, because Cotto gave him a good fight. I think Cotto's fight was a lot closer than the Pacquiao fight. He had a harder time against Maidana the first time.
I asked Robert Guerrero, if he had a rematch with Floyd, what would he do different? And Ruben, his dad said that they're going to chase chickens the whole training camp.
The whole training camp. Get ready to catch chickens, you know. You know, that's what they say, but
I think the Maidana blueprint of going from the first belt to the last belt is the most effective one.
Yeah, and Mayweather's not a runner, man. You know, I don't know why people think that, he's like, you know, chasing chickens. No, Mayweather stands in front of you. He has he's very, very defensive fighter and uses his shoulder a lot, and that's why you guys can't, that's why nobody can catch him. But he doesn't run. He doesn't waste. He doesn't spend 12 rounds running. I don't call that running. So, you know, it's Guerrero, you know, just like being Guerrero, you know, Ruben Guerrero being Ruben Guerrero. But Mayweather's not a runner. You know, he's a very defensive fighter, but he doesn't run. You know, so, you know, it's just, people just like to talk.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Sekpak.